So I started off this whole music thing when I was a kid. I got my first keyboard for Christmas in the mid-80s. And I wrote my first song when I was about 9 or 10. More about my reasons for such in the documentary Roots and Veins. When me and my mum moved to Norway, I continued primary school in Bærum, where I met a dude called Ola. Both of us were pretty heavy into our music early on, so we soon became best mates and started our first ever band, a synthesizer duo called Sjako, heavily inspired by Jean-Michel Jarre and the Commodore 64 game The Last Ninja. In my early teens, I started taking the train from Schlepen to Asker a lot, which is the neighboring commune to Bærum. Before I knew it, I was singing in a bunch of bands over there. The first one was called Inedeble, which we managed to spell wrong, even though we did actually find our band name from flicking through a dictionary. Me, Didrik, Daniel and Kristian practiced pretty much every weekend in Daniel's basement. Shout out to his mum, by the way, for putting up with us. Fun fact, I started singing in a band because none of the other members wanted to. Not even me. To be fair though, we did end up sounding a lot better than we did in that very, very, very early footage you just witnessed, if you ask me. Oskid had a really tight-knit music community going on in the 90s. So many great people that have influenced what I do to this day. And for that, I'm forever grateful. You take away the failing, and now you do it slow. You haven't got a clue about the length that I would go through. I often miss those days, really. And I miss singing in a band, like this one, called ObiWon. We used to play gigs at Club Tre all the time, which was, you know, the best underground scene in miles distance, if you ask anyone that hung out there in the 90s. You know, when everybody wanted to be Eddie Vedder. So sweet is the sound when the bell's chiming inside your ear. We started getting a few write-ups in the local paper and booked some gigs that we actually had to go out of town to get to. We made two albums that we released ourselves, Nose Job and Thoughts on Hold. We started off as more of a funk pop band, ended up as more of a rock band towards the end, really. Big shout out to Brikt, Martin, Peter, Øystein, Geir, Brynjar, and our sound whiz and glue, sometimes Jassa. And then there was Yelp. We were pretty hardcore. This bright light here is André Bach. He's the guy that involved us in making the soundtrack for the world's first base jump film, First Base. And the sequel, Second Base. André and his crew Oslo Base introduced us to that particular extreme sport, which was only just rising at the time, thanks to people like them, really. And, just blew our minds. Yelp had been at it for a few years already as a band when I humbly joined forces with them in the mid to late 90s. We had two singers, Paul and myself. Like all the other bands, I really miss playing with them. Paul, Øystein, Tommy, Magnus and Cash. When we got into that zone, man. It was ours. It was freedom. We rented a house together, and it was in an industrial area, so we could make loud music day or night, and there was a lot of love between those walls, and it was all the perfect setting for a lot of creativity. We played in a few small clubs and a couple of bigger ones, and we played a couple of festivals, a few snowboard events. We pretty much had the time of our lives, and I love those fuckers to death. But you know what they say, this too shall pass. So, But I wasn't quite finished as a musician or a songwriter yet. I feel I'd only just found my voice through, like singing wise, through all these different bands and projects and everything. So it was time to dig a little deeper into my expression otherwise, musically. See what happened.